Hello everyone, good evening and welcome to yet another session of Dear, Drop Everything and Read. I'm Karishma, an educator for verbal ability and reading comprehension at An Academy Plus, and I bring to you these beautiful sessions from various esteemed portals and websites and all those portals that you might hate or maybe the ones that dread you and scare you. I'm through this series, I'm trying to make these articles easy to understand, enjoyable, and something that you look forward to. We have spent almost an entire month in this series, and I see a lot of beautiful comments from a lot of you saying that you have become better readers, you started enjoying these articles, and also that your understanding of various genres in RC has improved. So that comes as a great news to me, and therefore a greater news for you would be that we are going to continue this series in the coming month as well. So without much ado, let's begin. A few announcements from An Academy. This is how you can contact me. My Telegram channel is known as Karishma's Vanquishers. My Instagram page is known as Vanquishers with an underscore in the middle. This is a really nice thing that I'm trying to do where I'm uploading information about various things related to grammar, vocab, fun facts, etc. So it's an basically English thing that is helpful for everybody and anybody who's you know interested in improving their language. I'm taking live cat classes at An Academy Plus, and in case you want to subscribe to An Academy Plus, please use my coupon code in order to get a 10% discount. These are a few free classes that are upcoming. I have already completed these two, and now on the coming weekend, I have these two really, really crucial and fun sessions. They are free for anybody to attend. You just need to apply this code to be able to unlock these classes, and you can check the details on my An Academy profile on the app or on the website. These are the details of the batches, various batches that we are starting in February. As you know, February is a crucial month. We have had a lot of enrollments already and students are all pulling themselves up by their socks and working really hard to ace the exam. Please join the gang so that you are, you know how much prepared you are and you can prepare accordingly as and when needed. These are the plus courses that I'm starting today. I'm beginning with a practice course on critical reasoning tonight, 7:30. It'll end at 9 p.m. It's a 90-minute session. And tomorrow, I'm starting with a vocabulary basics course. These are the upcoming courses for March as well. Last few days to enjoy 10% discount. The 10% discount is ending very soon. It'll no more be available. So the sooner the better. Please make sure that you subscribe within February. Also, Ask a Doubt feature, which was earlier available only to Plus students, An Academy has been relevant enough to extend this feature even to its non-Plus subscribers in order to let you know the expertise of the educators teaching here and also to give you an idea of how An Academy works and how efficient they are. So utilize this feature, browse through it and go about asking your doubts. These are the various subscription plans that are available. If you're a 2021 aspirant, a 12 or a 24-month plan is ideal. It's also very affordable if you compare it to any other place in the country. Plus, the EMI schemes make it really easy for you to spend that. Before we begin with the articles today, I want to ask you a very simple thing. What distinguishes a good writer from the rest of us? Or what distinguishes a good writer from a not so good writer? I'm sure you would say that the way they express themselves, before expressing something that comes into the picture is how they think. So today we are going to do an article that talks about something as simple as shoes, joote. Lekin, just think for a while after reading the article, how brilliant is the way of expression the author has used and how brilliant is his innovative style of thinking. He talks about things that probably nobody ever has talked about. I think this is what distinguishes you from the others. This is also an approach that you should remember while you are writing your WAT after a year, that everybody has got the same topic. You have the same idea to talk about, but a little imagination, a little innovation, a good knowledge of vocabulary, a command over grammar, and of course, a smooth flow of ideas will help you become an articulate writer. So it is important that if you really want to do good in, you want to do well in WATs, you should start writing a little right from now. A year is all that it'll take for you to perform exemplarily well a year down the line. Let's begin with today's article. What do shoes do? I am at the beach, enjoying that elemental pleasure, walking barefoot outside, when the texture of sand slipping through my toes and crunching against the tender flesh of my sole turns walking into a kind of communion or commingling with the physical world. Now, a pretty longer sentence, and I have always given this piece of advice, and I repeat, whenever you come across longer sentences, A, stop getting afraid. B, start breaking the sentences into multiple smaller parts, process them, and then read the sentence ahead. So let's read it again into smaller parts. I'm at the beach, enjoying that elemental pleasure. Elemental is very elemental, fundamental, basic. Walking barefoot, nange paon, outside. When the texture of sand slipping through my toes and crunching against the tender flesh of my soul turns walking into a kind of communion. So now I'm walking and I can feel the sand texture on the foot of my, on the sole of my foot. Also, I can feel the tender flesh of my soul being touched by that sand. Now this walking becomes a kind of communion. Communion is when you mingle in, or commingling. Commingling is also the same, merging with the physical world. So your body and the earth are combining where your foot is turning the beach sand. So a very simple thing like walking barefoot has been written very beautifully in these lines. I am reminded of the Neil Simon play Barefoot in the Park, which was written in 1967, where walking barefoot connotes the rambunctious, impulsive, back to nature sentiments in the 1960s. Now, I'm sure a lot of you will find it difficult. I have deliberately picked up this article because we've been doing articles of various different genres. Now, here the genre is very, the topic is very easy, but the way it has been written could be slightly tougher for some of you, if not all of you. So it's important to have a good command of vocab to be able to enjoy this article. Right now I'm helping you, but I would suggest that you read this article again as homework with the dictionary and find out the meanings where you didn't know the meaning. So rambunctious basically is anandamai, you know, something which is extremely cheerful, something that makes you boisterous, if you know that word, or ecstatic, if you know that word. In easy words, something that makes you extremely happy, all right? So that's rambunctious. Impulsive. Impulsive is when you act without thinking. I impulsively kicked him. So, bina soche maar diya. That is impulsive, okay? Back to nature sentiments. So, it is easy. So, ye jo play hai Simon ka, iski isko yaad aa gayi. Aur ye play is baare mein baat karta hai, connote karta hai. Rambunctious, impulsive, back to nature sentiments. जो कि पैदल चलने के साथ, नंगे पांव चलने के साथ एसोसिएटेड है. तो नंगे पांव पैदल चलना कोई आम बात नहीं है इस आर्टिकल में, तो बिल्कुल नहीं है. उसके साथ बहुत सारे फीलिंग्स एसोसिएटेड है, दैट इज़ व्हाट ही इज़ टॉकिंग अबाउट. फिर ही एक्सप्लेन्स इट. तो एक तो इसको ये प्ले याद आया चलते चलते, और क्या याद आया? एंटेयस, हु इज़ द ग्रीक डेमी गॉड. डेमी गॉड इज़ लाइक अ डिवाइन क्रीचर, ओके, हु ड्रू हिज स्ट्रेंथ फ्रॉम मदर अर्थ. सो देयर इज दिस कैरेक्टर इन ग्रीक माइथोलॉजी, एंटेयस. I'm going to cover a beautiful session on Greek mythology and the words that come from there in the coming vocabulary course, plus course. If you haven't attended it, please do. So, ye banda zameen par chalta tha, aur ye tab tak ajay tha. Ajay matlab invincible, the one who cannot be defeated. Jab tak iska ek paon zameen par hai, because usko power milti thi Mother Earth se. So, this is what it says. Who drew his strength from Mother Earth and was invincible as long as he remained in physical contact with the ground. So when he was walking barefoot on the strand, on the sand, the beach sand, author is thinking about, first he's talking about how his soul felt, then he's talking about Neil Simon's play, then he's talking about Artaeus, who's a Greek demigod. So three ideas being discussed in the first paragraph. This is an exercise that should be done every time you read an article that makes you uncomfortable. And I'm sure this might look very easy to you right now, but most people whom I asked, कि बेटा ये पढ़ लेना एज होमवर्क, मोस्ट पीपल डिडंट डू इट बिकॉज दे थॉट ये क्या लिखा हुआ है, हमसे नहीं पढ़ा जाएगा. दिस इज वाई आई वॉन्ट यू टू चेंज योर माइंड सेट अ लिटिल एंड वर्क अ लिटिल हार्डर एट सच आर्टिकल्स. इन हिज पोएम गॉड्स ग्रैंडियर, जेरार्ड मॉनले हॉपकिंस लेमेंट्स इज मातम करना, मून्स मॉडर्न एस्ट्रेंजमेंट फ्रॉम द डिवाइन. एस्ट्रेंजमेंट इज किसी को अनजान बना लेना, स्ट्रेंजर बन जाना, एलियनेट कर देना, जुदा कर देना, आइसोलेट कर देना. From the divine with the lines, the soil is bare now, nor can feel, nor, I'm sorry, this gets hidden here, nor can find feel being shod. Shod is basically, you know, the past tense of the verb shoe. All right, just give me a moment, I will correct this. Just a moment. All right, sorry for the issue. So this says, the soil is bare now, not can foot feel being short. So soil abhi bare ho gaya hai. तो जो डिवाइन फीलिंग अटैच्ड थी नंगे पांव पैदल चलने के साथ, वो कहीं ना कहीं हिल गई है. बीइंग शॉर्ट मतलब जब आप जूते पहन लेते हैं, तो वो जो डिवाइन फीलिंग थी चलने की वो हट गई है. द बीच इज वन ऑफ द फ्यू प्लेसेज वेयर द मॉडर्न ह्यूमन फुट कैन कंफर्टेबली अचीव अ स्टेट ऑफ एलिमेंटल अर्थली कॉन्टैक्ट. द ऑथर इज इन वन लाइन सेइंग दैट द मॉडर्न पर्सन फील्स द फुट ओनली वैन ही गोज ऑन द बीच. Because otherwise, most people never ever take off their slippers or shoes or footwear. They're always wearing something or the other. In the olden days, it was not the case. ज़्यादातर लोग जूते बहुत कम पहनते थे जब कहीं बाहर जाना हो. घर पे भी नंगे पांव चलते थे या ठंड में पहनते थे. आजकल पीपल वेयर फुटवेयर ऑल द टाइम. सो ओनली वेन यू गो ऑन द बीच यू गेट सम स्टेट ऑफ एलिमेंटल अर्थली कॉन्टैक्ट. आई एम हैविंग अ बैड डे. थैंक यू टेक्नोलॉजी. जस्ट गिव मी अ मोमेंट. The pen did not get selected. All right. So this is what it says. Elemental earthly contact ke liye beach jana padta hai abhi. But then the snack bar on the other side of the parking lot beckons. Kehte ki main chal hi raha tha lekin mujhe pukara kisne, snack bar ne bulaya. Jo ki parking lot ke dusre end par hai. My feet blissfully shoeless. Abhi tak bada maza aa raha tha. Badi bliss thi shoeless hone mein. Arrive at the curb to meet a jagged expanse of sun-baked asphalt, gravelly pebbles and the remnants of smashed beer bottles. Abhi tak my feet were enjoying everything, sand and you know, I was thinking about all beautiful things. And suddenly what happens, I thought, chalo snack bar jaate hain. The snack bar was, beckon is, you know, to haath aise karke bulana. This is beckoning, when you call by gesture. Okay. To mere jo pair the abhi tak bade blissfully shoeless the, abhi kahan aa gaye hain? एक जैगड एक्सपैंस इज लाइक अ वाइड एरिया. जैगड इज यू नो रगड, हैविंग शार्प एजेस और रफ एजेस. और यहाँ पर क्या है, सन बेक्ड एस्फॉल्ट है. सो एस्फॉल्ट इज लाइक द सॉल्ट विच इज देयर ऑन द सी शोर. सन बेक्ड है मतलब गर्म है. और ग्रेवली पेबल्स हैं, तो छोटे छोटे कंकड़ पत्थर वाला पाथ है. और क्या है, आपकी जनरेशन बियर बॉटल्स जो बाकी नशे में तोड़कर आती है, उसकी बच्चे कुछ कांच के टुकड़े हैं, रेमिनेंट्स हैं. And my idol, idol is, you know, the happy ideal place that we all enjoy, comes to an abrupt end. Aur mere sare acche mahol ki beer bottle ne aisi ki taisi kar di hai. In a heartfelt appreciation of the purpose and power of the humble shoe. And then now, how do I feel? I feel like extending a heartfelt appreciation. Bhai, thank you my shoes, my humble shoe. Shoes are humble, right? I mean, who worries so much about shoes? But then this is what it is saving you from. So unless you realize what a shoe saves you from, you will never probably thank them. I could walk to the snack bar barefoot. Main nange paon ja sakta tha snack bar. Suffering physical discomfort and having my attention monopolized by negotiating the hazards. Now again, a simple si cheez likhi hai usne, suffering physical discomfort. Lekin again, the sentence is made beautiful by writing. My attention monopolized. Mere attention par, mere dhyan par ek hi cheez ka adhikar hota. Negotiating the hazards. Agar aap nange pair chal rahe hain, beer bottle giri hui hai, gandgi hai, to aapka sara dhyan kahan hoga? Un hazards se negotiate karne mein, yani bachte chalne mein. Wahi aapka attention le lega. Agar aapke paas joote hain, to aapko attention ki zarurat nahi. You'll just walk casually, right? Barefoot in the parking lot, my being is focused down to a pair of feet painstakingly preoccupied with self-preservation and pain avoidance. So then how will I feel? My feet will only be preoccupied with one thing, self-preservation, khud ko bachana, aur kisi tarike se dard nahi hona chahiye, apan ko chot nahi lagni chahiye. If I only had my trusty sneakers, all the solid ground in the world would be available to me. Beautifully written. Joote pehen lete yaar, duniya ki sari zameen mere naam hoti. सिर्फ जूते पहन लेने से, क्योंकि फिर सोचना नहीं पड़ता कि कहाँ चलना है. द क्वार्टर इंच ऑफ मटेरियल बिटवीन माई फीट एंड द ग्राउंड वुड सेपरेट मी फ्रॉम द फिजिकल अर्थ, बट इन मेकिंग द वर्ल्ड एक्सेसिबल वुड क्रिएट अ वर्ल्ड. आई मीन, आई जस्ट फॉल इन लव विद दीज लाइन्स एवरी टाइम आई रीड देम. क्वार्टर इंच ऑफ मटेरियल है मेरे पाँव और ज़मीन के बीच में, और मुझे ज़मीन से दूर कर देता है, लेकिन वर्ल्ड एक्सेसिबल बन जाता है. और जैसे ही वर्ल्ड एक्सेसिबल बन जाता है, एक नई दुनिया क्रिएट हो जाती है जहाँ मैं बेफिक्र होकर पांव रख सकता हूँ. एज शांति देव द 8th सेंचुरी बुद्धिस्ट मंक ऑब्जर्व्ड, विद द लेदर सोल्स ऑफ जस्ट माय शूज इट इज एज दो आई कवर द होल अर्थ इन लेदर. सो एक्चुअली यू आर वेयरिंग लेदर शूज, राइट? बट देन यू आर कवरिंग द एंटायर अर्थ विद लेदर, राइट? सो बिकॉज देन यू कैन वॉक एनी वेयर. दिस लेदर प्लैनेट, दिस वर्ल्ड क्रिएटेड बाय शूज is different फ्रॉम द बेयर फुट वर्ल्ड, डिटैच्ड, एब्स्ट्रैक्टेड, इंसुलेटेड. तो ये जो दुनिया है जो आप जूते पहनकर नापते हैं, ये बिल्कुल अलग है उस दुनिया से जो आप नंगे पाँव नाप सकते हैं. ये डिटैच्ड है, इसका आपसे कोई अटैचमेंट नहीं है. ये एब्स्ट्रैक्टेड है क्योंकि आपको ये समझ ही नहीं आती या आप फील ही नहीं करते. और ये इंसुलेटेड है, इंसुलेटेड है मतलब ये लेयर्ड है, आपको नहीं फील होगी. इट इज़ अ वर्ल्ड लेस कंसर्न विद द टोपोग्राफी ऑफ द ग्राउंड, लेस अटेंटिव टू इट्स ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड टेक्सचर्स. परवाह ही नहीं है इन चीज़ों की. इट इज़ डलर एंड लेस सेंसिटिव. वाई विल यू बी सेंसिटिव एंड यू आर वेयरिंग शूज? नो पॉइंट, नो. एंड ऑब्वियसली इट्स डल बिकॉज यू डोंट फील एनीथिंग ऑन द फुट, ऑन द सोल ऑफ योर फुट. एट द सेम टाइम दिस आर्टिफिशलाइज कंडीशन रिलीजेज मी फ्रॉम द ग्रिप ऑफ माई फिजिकल सर्कमस्टांसिस एंड लेट्स मी ट्रांसेंड द फिजिकल वर्ल्ड टूवर्ड्स माई ओन डिजायर्स. अभी ये बड़ी आर्टिफिशियल कंडीशन है ना कि हम जूते पहन के चलते हैं, ये कोई हमारे बॉडी का पार्ट तो नहीं है. वी हैव क्रिएटेड दिस कंडीशन. लेकिन ये हमें आज़ादी देती है कि हम फिजिकल वर्ल्ड को अपने डिज़ायर्स के हिसाब से नाप सकते हैं. अब ये आई कैन क्लाइंब अप अ माउंटेन वेयरिंग शूज़ दैट आर मेंट फॉर ट्रैकिंग एंड क्लाइंबिंग. आई कैन प्ले फुटबॉल वेयरिंग फुटबॉल शूज़. आई कैन वर्क इन द किचन वेयरिंग स्लीपर्स. आई कैन गो टू द वॉशरूम वेयरिंग नॉन स्किड स्लीपर्स. आई एम क्रिएटिंग एन आर्टिफिशियल कंडीशन एवरीवेयर, बट देन दिस गिव्स मी फ्रीडम टू डू वॉट आई वॉन्ट. सो अगेन ही इज़ टॉकिंग अबाउट फेवर, नुकसान फ़ायदा, नुकसान फ़ायदा. ऑलराइट. माई एनकाउंटर एट द बीच पार्किंग लॉट डेमोन्स्ट्रेट्स an important aspect of how shoes phenomenologically for the wearer exist phenomenologically for the wearer. Phenomenologically basically a philosophy ka word hai jo ki baat karta hai. it's a branch of philosophy which talks about consciousness and experience. okay, to kehte hai ki ye beach parking lot pe mera jo encounter hua shoes aur ye puri kisse ke sath, isne mere ko dikhaya ki shoes keval wearer ke liye exist karte hai. A shoe lying in the cupboard is no good, right? A shoe is good only when somebody bears it. The most fundamental thing about my shoes is not the way they look or what they do, but how they affect my mobility, my freedom, and therefore my being. I'm sure if there are any women in the session, you know that you wear a pair of heels someday, you decide to look good, aur wahan us party mein chalna pad jaye, to kitna gussa aata hai. So shoes is not just about how you look, all right? Shoes are also about how free you feel. So were you able to dance at the party? Were you able to walk properly? Were you able to take a walk with the person that you liked in the party? A lot of things are dependent. So this is about mobility, freedom, and therefore your being. They act, even if at a subconscious level, as the literal foundation of understanding of myself, specifically as that understanding informs my sense of where I can go. So this has happened with me. I have a very minor flat foot. If I wear an uncomfortable pair of footwear to a mall where the, you know, the floor is really shiny and sparkly and therefore it's easy to skid, it's very difficult for me to walk. I would always, you know, want to wear a pair of sports shoes to a mall because my flat foot doesn't enable me to walk properly. So मैं कहाँ जा सकती हूँ और कहाँ नहीं जा सकती हूँ, ये भी किस बात पर अभी निर्भर करता है कि मैंने क्या footwear पहना है. So where can I go is also dependent on the footwear that I'm wearing. What kind of projects are within my sphere of possible future? So again, a little exaggeration there. मैं कहाँ कहाँ कौन कौन से project ले सकता हूँ और क्या future है? Mall जाए ना जाए, क्या पता mall में मुलाकात हो जाए, चार बात हो जाए, आँखें चार हो जाए, future बदल सकता है. A lot can happen over coffee, सुना है अभी? A lot can happen over shoes होना चाहिए. This phenomenological relationship between shoes and the possibilities they facilitate informs the anti-feminist trope. Trope is like a sentence which is common, like a maxim. That a woman's ideal state is barefoot and pregnant. ये anti-feminist बकवास बात है कि औरतें नंगे पाँव और pregnant, यही औरतों की पहचान है. Because पुराने ज़माने में औरतें घर पर काम करती थी और घर पर काम करने वाला कभी जूता नहीं पहनता था. सो ओनली द मर्द हु इज़ गोइंग आउट फॉर हंटिंग गैदरिंग और हु इज़ गोइंग आउट टू वॉर और ऑफिस वुड नेयर वेयर अ शू. अ वुमन हु इज़ एट होम प्रेगनेंट इज़ ऑलवेज बेयर फुट बिकॉज एज इट इज़ इन प्रेगनेंसी यू गेट सॉलन फीट एंड यू आर डूइंग हाउस होल्ड चोर्स. सो इट्स बेटर, इट्स ऑलवेज बेस्ट टू हैव नो फुट वेयर एट ऑल. द एंशियंट चाइनीज प्रैक्टिस ऑफ फुट बाइंडिंग, इवन मॉडर्न वेस्टर्न फैशन्स fetishization, fetish is when you get attracted by something, all right, of high-heeled women's shoes. Impractical or painful shoes reduce haptic spatial freedom even more severely than being barefoot does, reinforcing the sense in which shoes act as a symbolic foundation for human identity. Now, haptic is something which is related to touch. It's not a common word. And spatial simply comes from the word space, all right. तो अलग अलग चीज़ों की बात कही गई है। एक तो ये एंटी फेमिनिस्ट ट्रोप लिखा, फिर लिखा चाइनीज प्रैक्टिस थी फुट बाइंडिंग की, जिसमें पाँव बांध देते थे। वेस्टर्न फैशन का एक फिटिशाइजेशन है दैट यू नो व्हेन यू सी वी सी समबडी वेयरिंग अ गुड हाई हील यू गेट रियली इम्प्रेस्ड। सो पीपल फाइंड इट इम्प्रेसिव, नॉट जस्ट वेमेन, मैन ऑल्सो फाइंड इट वेरी इम्प्रेसिव ऑन अ वुमन। सो यू नो इम्प्रैक्टिकल एंड पेनफुल शूज दे रिड्यूस द फीलिंग ऑफ टच, दे ऑल्सो रिड्यूस द फ्रीडम दैट यू हैव मोर देन बींग बेयर फुट डज। तो नंगे पाँव चलने से चीज़ें दिक्कत हो रही है, लेकिन अगर आप खराब जूते पहनते हैं तो और ज़्यादा दिक्कत होगी, नंगे पाँव चलने से ज़्यादा तकलीफ होगी। इसीलिए शूज़ का जो सिंबल है, सिंबॉलिक फाउंडेशन है ह्यूमन आइडेंटिटी का, ये वापस रीइंफोर्स हो जाता है। द शूज स्नैक्स एज अ साइनिक डोकी ऑफ द वेयरर। साइनिक डोकी इज लाइक अ फिगर ऑफ स्पीच एंड अलंकार। आई एम श्योर यू रेड क्रिकेट न्यूज वेर इट सेज इंडिया वन द मैच। इंडिया वन द मैच, 11 पीपल प्लेइंग फ्रॉम इंडिया वन द मैच, राइट? वी आर अ कंट्री ऑफ 130 बिलियन पीपल, सो 130 करोड़ पीपल, सो दैट डजंट मेक सेंस। बट वेन वी से इंडिया वन द मैच, सो दिस इज सिनेक डॉकी, यू आर रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ होल बेस्ड ऑन अ पार्ट। ऑल राइट, सो आई हैव अ हेड एक एंड आई से आई एम अनवेल, दिस इज अ सिनेक डॉकी। हेड एक इज इक्वल टू माई एंटायर बॉडी बींग अनवेल, सो यू रिप्रेजेंट अ होल यूजिंग अ पार्ट। तो कहते हैं कि द शू स्टैंड एज अ सिनेक डॉकी ऑफ द वेयरर। तो है आपका जूता, लेकिन आपकी पूरी पर्सनैलिटी डिस्क्राइब करेगा। To talk about being in someone's shoes, that's a phrase, right? मेरे जूते पहनकर चलो तो पता चलेगा कहाँ काटता है। Empathy का idiom है, ये मुहावरा है। Or to think about what it is like to walk a mile in someone's shoes, even to imagine that you have some big shoes to fill, is to contemplate stepping into a different identity. So these are all idioms that come from shoes. कहता है कि भाई इन सब को सोचने के लिए जब आप कहते हैं कि आप मेरे जूतों में पैर डालकर देखिए, you should try and wear my shoes, you should try and sit here and you know, instead of listening to a YouTube lecture, you should try preparing for one, then you will come to know the amount of hard work it takes. Now when I'm asking you to do this, when I'm asking you to wear my shoes, what am I saying? I am asking you to take up a different identity. You will have to sit down and actually think that, okay, this woman has done something, so this is a different identity. As if the shoes, not the person wearing them, determines who you are. तो ये सारे idioms को पढ़कर ऐसा लगता है जैसे जब हम shoes की बात करते हैं तो वो सिर्फ shoes की बात नहीं है, वो वेयरर की भी बात है। और नॉट द पर्सन डिटर्मिन्स हु यू आर, सो ऐसा लगता है कि जूते डिटर्मिन करते हैं आपकी आइडेंटिटी, ना कि आप खुद। एज एल्विस सैंग, वेल यू कैन नॉक मी डाउन, स्टेप इन माई फेस, स्लैंडर माई नेम ऑल ओवर द प्लेस, एज लॉन्ग एज यू ले ऑफ ऑफ माई शूज, माई ट्रू लोकस ऑफ सेल्फहुड। सो बेसिकली दिस इज अ लिटरेचर रेफरेंस दैट ही इज गिवन हियर, वेयर ही टॉक्स अबाउट कि आप मेरे साथ कुछ भी कर सकते हो, लेकिन मेरे जूतों से दूर रहना है, बिकॉज माई शूज, यू नो, माई ग्रिप ऑन द ग्राउंड और माई फाउंडेशन इज माई ट्रू लोकस। लोकस इज लाइक माई पॉइंट ऑफ सिचुएशन ऑफ सेल्फहुड। मैं मेरे जूतों से हूँ, मैं मेरे पाँव से हूँ, राइट? इन दिस सबटेरेनियन वे वी आर आर शूज, हम हमारे जूते हैं, राइट? दिस शू, वन ऑफ द ओल्डेस्ट फॉर्म्स ऑफ ह्यूमन टेक्नोलॉजी, इज द प्रोटोटाइप। प्रोटोटाइप इज लाइक द सैम्पल ऑफ द मॉडल for all other technologies, a catch-all term for instruments and procedures that allow us to make the surly bonds of earth. Surly is basically bad-tempered, okay? So when you think that the earth is bad, you wear a pair of shoes and proceed into unnatural or unwelcoming environments. So whenever you want to go to such places, you got to have footwear. Vehicles such as cars, now read this, vehicles such as cars, boats and rocket ships are like shoes writ large. Writ is an old English में write का past tense wrote के बजाय writ होता था, तो ये वहाँ यहाँ ये wrote ही है, okay? If you are unable to see it here because of my video, I'm writing it here. तो ये जितनी गाड़ियाँ, boats, rocket ships, the ones that cover us, they are also shoes, but they are larger. Why are the shoes? Because they are protecting us from unnatural or unwelcome environment. Space suits, hazmat suits and vaccines are whole body shoes because they protect your whole body. Media of language and art can also be thought of as technology in this sense. Like shoes, they separate us from the direct experience to provide us with a new heightened reality. What does media do? What does entertainment do? It gives you a sense of heightened reality which is not real. What do shoes do? They make your feet feel the same all the time, irrespective of where you are walking. Whether you're walking on grass or you're walking on marble or you're walking on tiles, shoes don't let you feel anything. So in that context, everything mentioned here is like shoes. My short-lived reverie, ye sab ye soch raha hai, reverie is daydreaming, of a barefoot existence confronts me with the uncanny fact that shoes are not simply a technology that I can adopt or reject as the mood strikes me, but an artificial object my body has evolved to use. तो कहते हैं मेरी ये डे ड्रीमिंग जो थी ये आके रुक गई है, मेरा जो बेयर फुट एग्जिस्टेंस था ये कन्फ्रंट कर रहा है मुझे. और ये स्ट्रेंज फैक्ट कि शूज़ सिर्फ एक टेक्नोलॉजी नहीं है जिसे मैं अडॉप्ट कर सकता हूँ या रिजेक्ट कर सकता हूँ जैसे मेरा मूड बदले, बल्कि एक ऐसा आर्टिफिशियल ऑब्जेक्ट है दैट माई बॉडी हैज़ इवॉल्व टू यूज़. यू नो वी हैव बिकम इवॉल्व इन ऑर्डर टू बी एबल टू यूज शूज़. Although the earliest artifact of footwear known to archaeology is a 10,000-year-old sandal found in Oregon, paleoanthropologists that study the old stone age are known as paleoanthropologists, can tell that shoes came into widespread use among human populations around 40,000 years ago because of visible changes in the skeletal structure of the small toe. हमारा जो small toe है ना, little toe, उसका structure change हुआ है, जहाँ से वहाँ से हमें पता चलता है कि हमने जूते पहनना कहाँ से शुरू करा, some 40,000 years ago. Along with fire and language, shoes are one of those elemental technologies that have actually interacted with our DNA and become part of the habitat we are involved in. So language is a great part of our life. We cannot stay without it. We cannot stay without fire either. Similarly, we cannot stay without shoes. Our bodies have evolved to wear them. My reality check at the edge of the beach confirms that my relationship with my shoes is not merely an external relationship, but an internal one in which the shoes are in some sense part of my body. In this sense, even the most primitive technologies reveal the cyborg status of human reality. Cyborg is a portmanteau, a combination of words that comes from cyber and organism. You know, all those artificial limbs, etc., are cyborgs. They are half cyber, half organism because they're attached to your body. तो कहते हैं कि एक्सटर्नल रिलेशनशिप नहीं रहा अभी जूतों से, अभी ये इंटरनल मैटर है. इट इज़ लाइक अ पार्ट ऑफ माई बॉडी. इन दिस सेंस दी आर यू नो बिहेविंग एज साइबॉर्ग्स ऑफ ह्यूमन रियलिटी, एस्ट्रेंज फ्रॉम द अर्थ. हम पृथ्वी से, हम जमीन से थोड़े अलग हैं, एस्ट्रेंज हो गए हैं. वी लुक टू आर शूज टू एक्ट एज अ कनेक्शन रादर दैन अ बैरियर बिटवीन अ फिजिकल ग्राउंड एंड द ह्यूमन वर्ल्ड. सो इफ यू थिंक इट्स अ बैरियर बिकॉज इट्स सेपरेटिंग योर फुट फ्रॉम द अर्थ, but it's also a connection because if you don't wear this, you can't connect to various places. You may not be able to go everywhere. Let's do the last slide for the day and see how much can we cover. Get like all technologies, shoes present a fortune bargain. A fortune basically is something which is related to selling your soul to the devil kind of thing. You give up all your values and all your principles just because you want a material gain. That's a fortune bargain. तो शूज़ भी एक फॉर्चून बार्गेन दिखाते हैं. वट एवर एडवांटेजेस द बिस्टो आर ऑलवेज शैडोड बाय अ लिंगरिंग रिमोर्स. रिमोर्स इज गिल्ट, रिग्रेट. व्हेन आई रिटर्न टू माई बीच ब्लैंकेट, पुट ऑन माई स्नीकर्स, क्रॉस द पार्किंग लॉट एंड बाय द ब्यूर, माई थर्स्ट इज क्वेंच्ड, बट एन एनिमल रिजेंटमेंट सिमर्स समवेयर इन द रिसेसेस ऑफ माई अनकॉन्शियस. तो गया बीच ब्लैंकेट, मतलब जो पैर में जूते पहन लिए तो बीच कवर हो गया, तो बीच ब्लैंकेट स्नीकर्स, अच्छा नहीं, बीच ब्लैंकेट लिखा है, तो बीच पे चला, फिर स्नीकर्स पहने, पार्किंग लॉट क्रॉस करा, बियर खरीदी, प्यास बुझाई, लेकिन फिर उसको एक चीज़ है जो कुछ परेशान कर रहा है. सम रिजेंटमेंट, सम हेट्रिड इज देयर विद इन हिम व्हिच इज सिमरिंग, यू नो, बॉइलिंग इनसाइड इन द रिसेसेस ऑफ हिज अनकॉन्शियस. व्हाट इज इट? आई लव माई शूज, आई रिलाई ऑन देम, आई एम एग्जिस्टेंशियली डिपेंडेंट ऑन देम, बट आई ऑल्सो ब्रिसल एट द एक्सटेंट ऑफ दिस डिपेंडेंसी. तो आई लव देम, I'm dependent on them, but then I'm suddenly turned off that why am I so dependent on them? I don't like this dependence. I wonder if this vague disgruntlement is jal bhun jana, you know, bura maan jana, accounts for the fact that even as we elevate shoes into symbols of sex, status and achievement, we also denigrate them in ways that suggest that whereas shinier and more externalized forms of technology let us master our environment, shoes remind us of embodiment and evolutionary incompleteness. Even as they help us mitigate these conditions. So now this says I'm pissed off at the fact that why am I so dependent on them? And you know, this vague sadness or hatred that I suddenly feel, this comes because we elevate. Elevate is rise karwana, utha dete hum jooton ko. Kis level par? Symbols of sex, symbols of status, symbols of achievement. But we also criticize them. I've taught you this word in RC tones. Denigrate is to criticize them unfairly. Because we think they are shiny and you have, you know, all sorts of external forms of technology which helps us master an environment. So this is about the rest of the things. But shoes, they remind us about our evolutionary incompleteness. So we have evolved to wear them, even as they help us mitigate these conditions. So they help us fight conditions that are not so good for us, yet we have evolved to use them. There is a deep motive in many religious traditions according to which shoes are profane. Profane is, you know, irreligious, disrespectful. अनहोली आइटम्स. तो काफ़ी सारे रिलीजन्स में शूज़ बहुत अनहोली और बहुत ख़राब माने जाते हैं. When Moses discovers the burning bush, the first thing it tells him is that he needs to take off his shoes if he wants to walk on the holy ground. So this is about a Bible episode where Moses is supposed to walk on holy ground, और उसको सबसे पहला इंस्ट्रक्शन दिया जाता है जूते उतारो. मुस्लिम्स सिक्स एंड हिंदूज रिमूव दियर शूज बिफोर एंटरिंग अ प्लेस ऑफ वर्शिप. जॉन द बैप्टिस्ट एक्सप्लेन दिस रिलेशनशिप टू द मसीहा बाय सेइंग दैट ही वाज नॉट वर्दी टू लूज इन द स्ट्रैप ऑफ हिज सैंडल्स. टू बी श्योर दिस रेप्यूटेशन इज लिंक्ड टू द वे शूज कलेक्ट डर्ट एंड जर्म्स फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड. अभी ये सारे रिलीजन्स में मम्मी भी चिल्लाती है गंदे जूते बाहर करो एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. वाई इज ऑल ऑफ दिस एसोसिएटेड? वाई इज शू एन अनहोली आइटम? बिकॉज वो बाहर से क्या लेकर आ रहा है? डर्ट एंड जर्म्स. Bringing them into a clean interior, it tracks up the place. वो बाहर की एनर्जी घर में लेकर आता है. ये आपने अक्सर बड़ों के मुँह से सुना होगा. इंडिया में तो ये बहुत ही कॉमन है. As my mom used to say, so why should you not bring your shoes from outside inside the home? Because you have tracked all the place. You're coming from a bar, you're bringing that bar का energy inside your home. No, I don't want that. Keep your shoes outside. That's what moms would say. At the same time, shoes are commonly associated with personal soil of the wearer. कहते हैं कि जूतों में आपकी अपनी खुद की गंदगी है. Personal soil. Soil is, you know, when you soil your diaper, similarly you soil your shoe. So, and, you know, it's very, very common. So your shoes are basically considered dirty. It belongs to you. Nobody else wants to wear them. Making the stinky old shoe a cultural touchstone, a symbol of all that is foul and abject about the human body. So if you talk about entire, you know, human body, your clothes, your cosmetics, your shoes and everything, shoes are treated with disgrace. So nobody will say ki bhai chashma utar ke aao, but yeah, people will tell you joote utar karo. I am one of them. Anyway, so we end the article here. Let me check how much is left. So two slides are left. I wanted to do it, but I am unable to do it because of lack of time. So maybe we can pick this up again on Wednesday, finish it in 10 minutes and then start a new article. If you have anything else to say, or maybe if you want to give me your suggestions about this, you can type it in the chat box. As a homework, you could also read this entire essay. It's a huge one. But the homework that I'm giving you now is that you should try and finish this article within 12 minutes. Actually, it's a 16-minute read, ideally. But because you've read so much with me and you will not take time because you know kya likha hai, it should take you slightly lesser time. So you keep a timer for 12 minutes and try to finish it in maximum 14, okay? Also write a 100-word summary. Let me know if you want to continue this on Wednesday or you will complete the remaining on your own. The next session is on 24th, all right? So I'll see you on Wednesday at 4:30 again. And I'll ask you your feedback through the Telegram channel, or you can write it down in live chat or comment section. Please use this code if you are now willing to subscribe to Unacademy Plus. I hope you have a great day. Also, sit down and thank your shoes before you sleep tonight. Thank you and have a great day.